Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. In today's episode, let's take a look at private browsing in Safari. So the way private browsing works in Maverick's version of Safari is you go to the Safari menu and you go to private browsing to turn it on. You get this little warning here and it tells you basically exactly what private browsing is going to do, which is it's going to not remember the pages you visit, so it's going to not add the pages you visit to your search history, and it's also going to not remember your search history. So when you actually search for something up here rather than entering an address, it's not going to remember that either. And it's also going to not remember any autofill information. When you fill in forms, it's automatically just going to disregard that, not put that in your autofill. Now to do this in Yosemite, you can see it's a little bit different. Instead of actually going to the Safari menu, you go to the File menu and you see where it says New Window here. There'll be the opportunity to open up a new private browsing window, and everything in that new window, all the tabs you open there, will be in private browsing mode. But you can still leave a window open with regular browsing mode, so you can have kind of both side by side if you want. So what does private browsing really do? Most people don't understand it. It doesn't actually do very much. As I said, it does those three things, but what does that really accomplish? Because your history is still being recorded and tracked elsewhere. If you're looking for a way to privately browse the internet where, say, your ISP or the company or organization you work for doesn't know where you're going, private browsing is not going to do that at all. They're still going to be able to track you through their servers. There's still a footprint left through your ISP of where you're going. And there also may be a footprint on the site you're going to. So if you're logged into, say, sites like Google, Facebook, etc., they're still going to remember what it is you're doing because you're logged into those accounts. It's just your local history, the stuff stored on the hard drive of your computer, that's not going to be recorded. So what good is it? Well, it is good for hiding your browsing history from somebody that you share a computer with. Somebody doesn't have access to all that stuff at Google and Facebook, assuming they don't have your passwords, of course. If you're, say, shopping for a gift for somebody or planning a surprise party, well, it can come in handy because there's been plenty of surprise gifts and parties that have been spoiled by people simply looking at search history in the browser. It's also very useful if you're not using your own computer. If you're using a public computer or borrowing a friend's computer and you want to do some work on there, you might want to go into private browsing mode so you're not adding your search history and your autofill information to theirs. It could be just not that you want to hide something from them, but that you don't want to clutter up their work with your work. It's also good as kind of a low-level measure. Like, for instance, say you're using your work computer to shop around for your next job. Well, you can't guarantee that your IT department isn't knowing exactly what you're doing, but it may make you feel a little bit better to know at least if somebody were to come and sit at your cubicle and look at your search history, they wouldn't see all that stuff. Now let's say you're not using private browsing mode and you decide that maybe you should have been. Well, it's easy to clear your tracks here because all you need to do in Safari is go to History, Show History, and you can see all your history there, and you can actually clear this very easily. Go in History and then you go Clear History here, and you can clear it and you can see it empties it out. You can also clear out autofill information by going to Safari Preferences, going to Autofill here, and any one of these you can edit here. You can see all the list, everything in the list there, and you can select one and remove it, select multiple ones and remove it. I'll just Command A to select all. If you have none selected, you can remove all as well. So you have the opportunity to do it even after the fact. And if you're on a public computer and you realize that you've been using Safari and you have had your search history recorded and you have had your autofill things put in, you can use these to clear them out afterwards. Now, private browsing also does a couple other things. With cookies, what it does is it doesn't stop storing cookies. It just kind of resets them when you're done with private browsing. So it's very useful, for instance, if you want to log into a separate account, say a separate Google account, separate Facebook account, something like that, to start private browsing, log into another account, and then log out. And when you're done, you can then turn off private browsing and your cookies should reset to how they were before. So if you're having trouble with some sites going back and forth between different accounts, private browsing may help. Also, if you use the iCloud feature where it shares your history between devices. So you see what tabs are open on your Mac when you're looking at your iPad. Private browsing will turn that off temporarily. So if you're shopping for gifts for somebody and they're on the iPad, they won't be able to see what page you're looking at on the Mac. So private browsing isn't something that the typical user needs to use at all. If you're using one Mac for multiple people, everybody should have their own user account, so you really don't need private browsing then. And it really doesn't protect you from anything like having your employer knowing what you're browsing or having your ISP knowing what you're browsing. So it's not as private as you may think. So it's kind of a specialty tool, but it's good to know that it's there in case you need it. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now.